guitars. My Dobro. This is my lap steel. It's my new favorite lap steel. It's tiny. My Gibson J200. Look at this case. This case is, it's got air coming through it. You can see daylight through this case. Here's a tiny little magnetone amp for growl. The stuff I won't let anyone else touch because it's got my 16-second digital delay. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 guitars.
I got the idea for this project called Lovers sometime in the mid-80s.
A bunch of pedals.
And
it's important to remember that thinking about it is one thing. Thinking you would actually do it is another thing. So the fact that I never thought I'd actually do it was, it made it so easy to think about it forever.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
In the 60s, there are many, many records made that would fit into the category of the mood music record. It was the record that, let's say, a suave bachelor might put on just as the martinis had been mixed, before the lights were dimmed and before sitting down a little too close on the couch or any of those things that were all imagined by people looking for romance. Lovers is really more of an updating or a personalization of a mood music record.
We'll be right down. Bye-bye. It's nice, actually.
He is on time, see?
This is book one. That's book two.
What hath I wrought?
Time to be done.
Couldn't have done it without you, that's for sure.
Originally, of course, I was going to arrange everything.
Sexy is right.
A lot of this music for Lovers needed to be done by an expert. It needed to be done by somebody who knew how to get traditional classic sonorities from a large group, not just sort of, I guess, what you would call a potentially visionary, but possibly quite awkward orchestrations.
There's just a big C minor chord, but I think some free jazz drums in there might be, make it sound a little less
cool.
Bizarre and bizarrely stark.
So the bottom, is this for
bass?
Devin's part as well?
That's bass.
Nels, so you know what? I'm not sure if I can really do this. I said, well, go on. And he was saying, you know, this might be outside my comfort zone. I said, well, that's the reason to do now. You just have to absolutely lean forward and fall into it with no hesitation.
Michael said, I think what we should do is minimal lush. And I said, that's it. Minimal lush is it.
Having 21 people in the orchestra, I know it's not going to sound 100% like I imagine it, so you have to move with it and shape things. There's one little button that can be pressed or massaged, and you can open up a whole new world.
About the mood, what makes us think about love, sex, romance, loneliness, passion. But it's instrumental music. It's all meant to be as easy to ignore as it is to listen to carefully, because that's what mood music records are. Ultimately, I think that concept of this record is about the multiplicity, the unfathomability, the mystery, the power, the intoxication of love, and the fact that it's so powerful, and it's changed my life, and it drives my life, but I don't understand it.